Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Future Nightya back with another sponsored video. Shout outs to Solarpop and Unplug Yourself for sending me this package. We are doing a bit of a close-up view today, so I'm not sure if you guys can see this in the picture. It's just a really, really big box. Oh, hitting the camera there. It's just a really big box with something inside. Not sure what yet. Have an idea. But we will just have to wait and see. I've got my trusty Stanley knife here. You know, always got to be safe. And yeah, we're going to cut it open, see what it is, open it up on the channel, and potentially have a giveaway at the end of this video. So stay tuned for that. And yeah, just give me a second to open it up. So inside of our mystery box, we have ourselves a booster box of Blazing Vortex. Quite a incredible set, the most recent set that's just come out. Unfortunately, because of the weather conditions overseas, this has arrived in South Africa a little bit late, but not too late that it is not relevant anymore, you know, to the metagame and to casual players. This set has had quite bad reviews amongst players, especially overseas and here, but to be honest with you, I think this is a really, really good set. Reason being is there's no cards in here that are absolutely insane, aside from maybe one or two that, you know, you have to shell out money to get a hold of, but rather there's commons and there's supers and there's, you know, lower rarity cards in the set that actually make a huge impact to the game, whether you're playing meta in the form of Virtual World or you're playing casually in the form of, I believe they're called War Rocks, which is a very old school type deck archetype where they focus a lot on the battle phase and attacking monsters, which is really, really good for returning players or newer players to teach them, you know, the battle phase game mechanic. So overall, pretty good set. Also, obviously, we've got the cover monster here. I believe it's Armed Thunder Dragon level 10 is a secret rare in the set. So what they've basically done is taken creatures, monsters from the anime and reworked them with new effects and modern day effects to make them relevant. And they're actually in the set as well, which is very, very exciting. They are such awesome creatures. And I mean, you can just see him. He looks fantastic. So we're going to be opening this up. I'll be speaking about some, if not most, of the cards as the review portion of this opening, and then depending on what we pull, there might be a giveaway at the end of this video. If there isn't a giveaway in this video, there will be a giveaway in my next video, which will be a opening on the Frozen Chains, or Freezing Chains, I believe. Freezing Chains. Opening up of that structure deck, as well as a giveaway of 3 of that structure deck. Yes, you heard right. So 3 structure decks will be given away in my next video, including the one that I open up. That will allow for a newer player or even a veteran player to get their hands on those structure decks and to build the Ice Barrier deck. But for now, guys, let's just jump straight into this. Again, trusty Stanley knife so we don't hurt ourselves, and the cards inside. So we'll open it up. I'm just going to put this to the side. I'm trying a different filming technique for this one, simply because the last one, it was quite difficult to read the cards at such a distance. So this is to hopefully make it easier for a lot of people to read. And we will start with the left side, taking out all the packs on the left, and let's just get right into it. First pack, let's see what we have. The Fabled Abanak, Guitar Gunnard's Doingunus. Oh, we get some of the new Metal Foes cards in the set. I actually didn't realize that. That's very, very cool. Hopefully that they unban Electromite in the next ban list, upcoming ban list, which should be, I believe, beginning of March, which is quite cool. Actually, I didn't know that these were in the set. Knight of Armored Dragons. So here is what I was speaking about earlier, the retrain of older cards, you know, fan favorite cards such as the Armed Dragons and the leveled Armed Dragons, which is very, very cool. This is the Ritual Monster. And then there we go, our first hollow Warrock Fortier. Excuse me if I butcher these names, but yeah, this is the new strategy, the new archetype that comes in the set. Like I said, very focused around the battle phase. I believe this one is, if your Earth Warrior monster battles after damage calculation, you can add one Warrock card from your deck to your hand, except itself. Then all Warrock monsters you currently control gain 200 attack until the end of your opponent's turn. If this card is sent from your monster zone to your graveyard by opponent's card effect, you can special summon one level 5 or higher Warrock monster from your hand or deck. You can only use each effect of Warrock Fortier once per turn. So like I said, very battle phase focused, attack buffs and whatnot. Then we've got Ancient Warriors Saga. Ancient Warriors getting some ports in the set. That deck is looking quite crazy at the moment, let me say. So any support that they get is definitely welcomed. Line Equation Cannon. Dream Mirror Recap. Dream Mirror is never really taking off, but this art is quite cute. Armor Dragon Ritual. I believe this is to summon our Knight of Armor Dragon. So that's pretty cool, getting the ritual spell as well as the ritual in one pack. So obviously as this opening goes, we will be opening up quicker as we see more duplicates. But I will be stopping and reviewing some of the cards that pique my interest and that I think, you know, should pique other people's interest as well. We've got another Metal Foe card. Radiant Vorescence, I believe. That is a beautiful, beautiful card. My word. Digital Bug. Fairy Archer. Also quite a stunning. Plant monsters. You know, plants not having the greatest support in recent times. But there's always a little bit every set. Hopefully getting them to a point where they're playable. Ancient Warriors Rebellious Lu Feng. My word, he is stunning. That is a beautiful card. Again, like I said earlier, Ancient Warriors getting more support, becoming a more and more, I believe, slept on deck. Dogmatica Genesis. Also quite cute art on that one. Warrock Ordeal. Stairway to Fabled Realm. And Synchro Transmission. Ooh, Windwitch Blizzard Bell. The Windwitch is definitely being a fan favorite in the community for quite some time now. I'm not too sure how this support would fit in with that archetype, but I know it is definitely being anticipated by Windwitch players and Spellcaster players, to be quite frank. Fabled Marcassia. We have our Gunnards again. Ooh, that's quite cool. Sprint the Iron Dash Dragon. I think this has to do a little bit with Dogmatica, if I'm not mistaken. I believe the Fallen of Albaz is a Dogmatica card. So that is quite interesting. We've got another Warrock Gaktos. Tilted Try. I love these cards with the goblins and the Pot of Greeds and everything. That is very cool. When you draw for your normal draw in your draw phase, you can reveal one of those cards, place it on the bottom of the deck, and if you do, draw one card. So you basically redraw your draw phase. When you draw a card by a card effect, you can reveal one of those cards, send this card to the graveyard, and if you do, place that card on the bottom of the deck, and if you do that, draw one card. So it's almost like a redo twice. We've got the Dream Mirror card again. We've got our Armor Dragon Ritual again. And then Fabled Treason. So Fabled cards getting released in the set, which is quite interesting. Definitely an older archetype that was also, you know, a fan favorite. Them getting some new support in the set. So obviously, what are we hoping to pull from the set? Definitely a Pot of Prosperity or our Link 5 Mommy, as I like to call her, the underworld of the goddess of the underworld. Definitely the best cards in the set. This looks insane. Springus Captain Sargus. That looks so cool. Very, very interesting card. Neroi, the Dream Mirror Disciple. More Dream Mirror support. More Fabled support. The Fabled Abnak. S-Force Showdown. Ooh, our first Ultra Rare, Seven Cities of the Golden Land. I believe this is the fusion card for the Aldlich strategy. The Golden Lord has a fusion in this set, which this card looks insane. During your main phase, You can fusion summon one fusion monster from your X-Trick, using only zombie monsters from your hand or field as fusion material. If a zombie monster is special summoned by a card effect, except during the damage step, you can target one set card in a spell and trap card zone, so yours or theirs. That set card cannot be activated this turn, even if this card leaves a field. You can only use each effect of 7 cities of the Golden Land once per turn. That's very interesting, so it's almost got like a Trickstar Light Stage kind of effect along with the fusion, and that is just a beautiful card. Very, very nice. We'll set that aside as one of our first, you know, foils other than a super. Synchro Transmission, we've seen already. Springus Blast. Ice Breeze Refrain. This definitely has to do with the Wind Witches. We can see that just by the art. And then we've got a Steel Star Regulator and Machine Link Monster. Link Monsters always making a huge change in the game since their release. So this is potentially one to look out for in the future. So, I mean, like I said, Link Fire Mommy, Pot of Prosperity is the cards we're looking to get. And potentially maybe a Starlight. I myself have never pulled one. I've held one before, but pulling one would be a whole different experience. So we've got Springgas Rocky, Heavy Metal Foes Amalgam. Again, with the Metal Foes card, that is very, very cool. They need that support. They need Electromite back. This is our third copy of this Morphos card. Another Knight of Armor Dragon. And then we've got a Dream Mirror card, the Dream Mirror Tormentor. That is also quite interesting art that we have there. A lot going on there. Hopefully Dream Mirrors eventually get to a point where they can be played at a rogue level. This is a stunning card. The more I look at it, the more beautiful it becomes. But right now they don't have what they need to compete. Aurok Orpus, another Armored Dragon Ritual. I think that's our third for that one. Springan's Call, and then Aurok Skylar. Once again, shout outs to Solarpop and Unplug Yourself for sponsoring this video. They sent me this box to open up. Obviously, it doesn't affect my review of the cards, but it is very much appreciated. Thank you to Solarpop and Unplug Yourself. I'm not even going to attempt to say that. Aman Okojaki. You cannot activate the effects of other special summon monsters with the same attribute as this card, Light. Once per turn during the main phase of this card's owner, quick effect, you can give control of this card to your opponent. Then you, the activating player, can make this card become any attribute until the end of the next turn. So it's almost like a form of disruption. I read it because I've never seen this card. That's actually quite interesting. Arm Dragon Blitz. Got the OD Arm Dragons on that one. Dream Mirror Disciple, Digital Bug, Ancient Warriors Lo Feng again, Pendulum in Encore, excuse me, Steel Star Regulator, and S4 Specimen, and Stairway to Fabled Realm. Machina and Clasper. The Machinas are actually quite a surprising rogue deck, definitely one to look out for. I believe the three structure decks are still widely available here in South Africa and overseas. Definitely, I'd say, worth picking up, especially as a newer player. They have very, very, very strong monsters. So, yeah, just getting some support in the set. Fairy Archer, Iguana, Wind Witch. Yes, boys! This is what we're after, Ojama Pink. That is so cool. So for those of you who know me in real life, I'm a huge Ojama fan. My custom mat that I got from my girlfriend actually has all the Ojamas dancing around a picture of us. Obviously excluding Ojama Pink because he's new, but that is so cool. So we finally have Ojama Pink. This works with the strategy of blocking off your opponent's zones. So their only win con really is to block off the opponent's zones so that they can't summon monsters. But obviously with backrow decks, the strategy isn't that strong, but it's still great to get a hold of this little guy. I'm actually going to put him aside. Boys, pack was godly. We pulled a Pot of Prosperity, boys. This card is the chase card of the set. This is insane. Pot of Prosperity, banish 3 or 6 cards of your choice from your extra deck face down. For the rest of this turn, after this card resolves, any damage your opponent takes is halved. Oh no, but guess what, you just dug 6 cards into your deck. Also, excavate cards from the top of your deck equal to the number of cards banished. Add 1 excavator card to your hand, place the rest on the bottom of your deck in any order. You can only activate 1 pot of prosperity per turn. You cannot draw cards by card effects the turn you activate this card, but you can still add. That is insane, ladies and gentlemen. I do have some sleeves here in case this happened. I'm glad it did. So we'll quickly put him in a sleeve. That is very, very cool. Once again, shout outs to Solarpop and Unplug Yourself for sponsoring me with this booster box. That is very, very cool. Dual Avatar Ascendants, Dogmatica Genesis, Spring and Call. Sorry, everything else in this pack is kind of dead. Parametal Foes Fusion, a new fusion card for Metal Foes. That's very awesome, especially considering half of their strategy is fusing. Right, so next best card of that is the Link 5 Mommy, or Touchwood, maybe a Starlight Rare, maybe. Fabled Mycosia. This crazy Amun card. We've got our Gunnards again. We've got our Radiant Fluorescence here again. EMR. Tribute 1 machine monster, then toggle 1 card on the field. For every 1,000 original attack of the tribute monster, destroy those cards. The thing is, this card, you actually have to destroy cards to fully resolve it. So not an insane card, but quite nice just to have a lot of removal, especially in machine decks like maybe Orcus or the Machina strategy. Fable Treason. Sorry, I can't speak. I'm so excited. Tilt a Try. And then our fourth copy, Armor Dragon Ritual, Warrock Orpus, and that's it for that pack. I'm going to speed it up a little bit now. I think I've spoken about most of the archetypes and supporting cards that we've gotten in the set. Obviously, I'll stop on the higher rarity stuff. And I'm quite interested by these Sprint cards, or Spring, or very, very strange, very interesting cards. Heavy Metal Foes, again, always welcome. Machina, Amano, Warrock Fortier, S4 Specimen, Stairway to the Fabled Realm, Ice Breeze Refrain, Archfiend Staff of Despair. That is a very old school looking Yu-Gi-Oh card, my word. So we've only pulled 1 secret and 1 ultra so far. That's very interesting, and we're almost done with the left side. Neroi Disciple, another Ojama Pink, God bless Ojama Pink. Springen's Brunga, these guys look insane. Heavy Metal Foes. Cordius the Triphasic Dealman. This is apparently a new super poly target. Very crazy, insane looking card. 1 Synchro Monster, 1 XYZ Monster, and 1 Link Monster. Not a lot of boards end on that, but obviously you could just make one of those yourself, and as long as your opponent has the other two, you could super poly away their board. Yeah, pretty insane card. I believe his effects are determined by what you use to fuse him. No, you can pay life points in multiples of 2,000 and apply 1 of the following effects for every 2,000 life points paid. Add 1 spell trap card from your graveyard to your hand, so recursion. Destroy 3 cards your opponent's control, non-targeting. This turn, this card gains attack equal to half of the difference between your life points and your opponent's. Also, your other monsters cannot attack. So it's like an OTK machine, basically. Very, very cool card. I think I'm going to sleeve him up as well. Very nice. Then we've got Reinforcements of the Army Troops. I love this continuous Reinforcements of the Army story. Parametal Flows Fusion. Breath of Acclamation. Crazy card. Looks like a ritual card for wind monsters. Interesting. Dual Avatar Ascendance. Dual Avatar, obviously, being from, I believe, the most recent previous set to Blazing Vortex. Springen's Captain Sargus. Surely this archetype will get more support in the future. Giga Thunder Gyclops. We've got another Gun Guard. Tri Brigade. Our third Lufeng. That's a playset of Lufengs. Ancient Warrior Saga, Appropriate, Dreamer Recap, Dogmatica Genesis, Springen's Blast. I believe we're on the last three packs of the left side. Again, I'm just going to pick it up now, unless we stumble upon something incredible. Springen's Beetle, he's a new Springen's. I haven't seen him yet. Quite an interesting card. Springen's Rocky, oh, look at that, two at a time. S4 Showdown, Akina and Clapspar. Oh, this card, this is what I was speaking about, how the lower rarity stuff is actually what's the most relevant stuff. This is a monster trap, so it's a trap card that turns itself into a monster, and I believe it does some kind of disruption. So, special summon this card as an effect monster. 1800 attack, 1800 defense. This card is also still a trap. Once per turn, when your opponent would special summon a monster, while this card is in your monster zone, you can send to the graveyard one continuous trap in your monster zone that was special summoned from the spell and trap card zone, negate the summon, and if you do, destroy that monster. When this card in the monster zone is destroyed by battle, you can destroy the monster that destroyed this card. So it seems like it's just a piece of removal in general, can negate a summon, and can, you know, potentially blow up something that's attacking you. So it's a good form of defense and offense. That's very, very good card. Again, a lot of the commons and a lot of the supers, in particular supers, have meta relevance. Arcfiend's Staff of Despair, Dual Avatar Ascendants, Tilted Try, and Ice Breeze Refrain. So, two ultras, one secret on the one side. That makes sense considering you should get two secrets and four ultras. Springus Barbranga, Fabled Marcosia, Fury Archer, Springman's Pedal. Whoa! Mater Ector, Giga Boros. Two level 3 monsters. Hey, I can play this in Burning Abyss. Gains 500 attack and defense for each card in your hand. You can only use each of the following effects of himself once per turn. You can detach one material from this card, attach one Mater Ector monster from your deck to this card's material. During your opponent's main or battle phase quick effect, you can add one card attached to this card to the hand. Huh, interesting. Very, very interesting card. Quite an insane looking card as well. Interesting. Springland's Call. Archfiend Staff of Despair. War Rockadeal. And then Raging Storm Dragon Beaufort IX. So that's 9. Crazy card. I suppose this is what that ritual spell for when monsters was used for. A lot of stuff that seems like it'll get support later on. You know, I've never heard of the Meteor Act or monsters before, and that's the first card I think we've pulled, you know, for that archetype. We've got another Sprint. Oh, playset of a John Pink. Yes, boys, that's what we needed. Heart of Armor Dragon, Fairy Archer. Oh, now the Ultra Rare, Wind Witch Diamond Bull. Okay, pretty insane card. Huge wall of text there. Obviously, I'm just going to leave it on screen for those of you who want to read it. Again, I don't want this video to be too long. Beautiful card. I think we're going to just sleeve her up as well. And I think I am actually going to sleeve up that ultra rare that I got, the Aldrich ultra rare, just in case. Cool. Then we've got Fabled Treason, Orok Adil, Virtual Gate. See, once again, another situation where our commons and rares are the most meta impactful. Virtual Gate, this is an insane card for Virtual World, just a form of recursion. Absolutely insane card. Surprised we only have one so far, and then Warrock cards. Moving on to the right hand side. Apologies for this video being so long. I did know quite a bit about the set, but of course, you do get overwhelmed by the new cards. On Dragon Lightning, that is an insane looking card. S-Force Professor Digama, Springen's Rocky, Digital Bug, S-Force Justify. Our fourth Ultra, I believe. So that's it for our Ultras. Pretty crazy looking card. The S-Force strategy I know has been getting quite a little bit of hype. Hopefully they again get support later on that makes them, you know, a bit more relevant, meta relevant, and a bit more, you know, competitive. Springen's Call, Springen's Blast, Fabled Treason, Reinforcements of the Army Troops. Giga Thunder, Geklops, Radiant Iridescence, Fabled Abnik, Windwitch Blizzard Bowl, another meta staple in the form of a super rare, Psychic Eraser Laser. Send one monster your opponent controls that was special summoned from the extra deck to the graveyard. Then your opponent gains life points equal to the original attack and defense of the monster, whichever is higher. You can only activate once per turn. This adds Dragoons. Dragoons can't be targeted. Send it to grave. Oh, they gain 3,000? Doesn't matter. You got rid of the problem. Insane card. Definitely would suggest picking up a playset while these guys are 40, 50 cents. Austrian Stock Despair, Springless Blast, Parameter Force Fusion, Tilt to Try. I think we've pretty much covered all the commons so far. You know, haven't seen anything new for quite a while. So I'm just going to quickly go over the commons to get to our foil. Unless I see something new. You know, Tri-Brigade, Akina, Metal Foes, Ojama Pink, Virtual World Card, Warrock, and then obviously all of these you've seen already. This is again the new Virtual World Card. This card is absolutely insane. Also part of their new strategy, just making them even more powerful than they already are. Insane card. Moving on, Ojama Pink. Alright, Ojama Pink, I think we've seen enough of you. Arm Dragon Lightning, S-Force Professor, Windwitch, Springens Watch, first foil Springens card that we found, Armor Dragon Ritual, Primera Recap, Parametal First Fusion, Warrock, Skylar. Trying to keep this video below 30 minutes. Giga Thunder Gyclops, Heaven Metal Foes Amalgam, Fabled Markisia, Springens Vanguard, Arm Dragon Thunder level 3, very, very cool looking card. Again, the retrain of the originals. That's very awesome to see. Ancient Warrior Saga, Linear Equation Cannon, Steel Star Regulator, Archfiend, Star Despair. So according to my math, we should have one more secret rare. Hopefully touch wood, a Starlight rare. That'd be nice. But we'll just have to wait and see. Ranga, Peedle, Arm Dragon Blitz, Wind Witch, Freezeball. Is this our fifth? This is our... No. I can't do math. This is our fourth Ultra Rare, I believe. Yes, it is. Oh wow, that's okay. Sorry guys, I can't do math. Windwitch Freezeball, that is a beautiful card. If all monsters you control are Windwitch monsters, minimum one, you can special summon this card from your hand. You can only use this effect of Windwitch Freezeball once per turn. Once per turn during your main phase, you can increase this card's level by one, and when synchro monsters that were summoned using this card as synchro material cannot be destroyed by battle. So that's like their whole strategy, is to get our Clear Wing and Crystal Wing, and then manipulating levels to synchro with into wind synchros. Beautiful card. Let me quickly sleeve her up. Looks like this box was the Windwitch box, as far as I can tell. That's very, very cool. Raising Drag Storm Dragon, Fuel Avatar, Reinforcements of the Army Troops, Synchro Transmission. Okay, now we should only have one secret rare left. S-Force Professor, Arm Dragon Lightning, Parametal Foes Malcaster, Digital Bug, Great Sansi Gold Golgonda. Looks like this is for the Springman's cards. Field Spell, I believe. Springman's Call. Steel Star Regulator. Springman's Blast. Linear Equation Cannon. Springman's Rocky. Heavy Metal Foes Morgum. Windwitch Blizzard. Amon Kuzi. This Meteoractor card again. Actually quite insane card. Definitely think this is a little bit underrated. Again, the supers being the highlights of this opening. Fable Treason, IC, and then another Virtual World card. We're down to our last two packs, ladies and gentlemen, which means there should be a secret in at least one of them. Let's go with the left for now. S-Force Professor, Springman's Rocky, Arm Dragon. Oh, I see something shiny, I think. Arm Dragon Blitz, my heart is pounding. Trial Brigade, Fabled, and Wraith. Oh, wow. Quite an interesting looking card there. Still to try. Breath of Acclimation, Dogmatica, Warrock, Skylar. Alright, my heart is pounding, ladies and gentlemen. So I don't think we're going to get a Starlight. Usually a Starlight doesn't replace a Secret Rare. But this should then be a Secret Rare. Springins, Captain Sargus, Giga Thunder, Giklops. I think I've already spoiled it for myself. Arm Dragon Blitz. Oh no, I haven't. Spingled Iron Dash Dragon. Boys, I think we got a very good box today. Pot of Prosperity and Aldrich the Mad Golden Lord. Now, this card is not actually used in a lot of Aldrich strategies, but my word, is he vicious. Look at that. So not only did we get the fusion card, but we also got the fusion monster. That's very, very cool. We'll give him a quick read just to finish off the video. This card names becomes Aldrich the Golden Lord while on the field. That's obviously so all your traps can trigger. Cannot be destroyed by battle or card effect. You can tribute one zombie monster, then target one face-up monster your opponent controls. Take control of it. But it cannot attack or activate its effects this turn. You can only use this effect of Aldrich the Mad Golden Lord once per turn. Very, very interesting card. Snatch Steel on Legs, essentially. Awesome card. Breath of Acclimation, S4 Specimen, Linear Cogent Cannon, and Pendulum on Core. Let's quickly sleeve up our Golden Lord, the Mad Golden Lord, and we can quickly lay out our pools. And I just want to say once again, thank you so much to Solarpop and Unplug Yourself for sponsoring this video. You know, great video. Pretty great pools, definitely awesome. Please stick around for my next video, which will be uploaded tomorrow, which will be the giveaway of the Freezing Chains structure deck. Three of them, in fact. I hope everybody enjoyed this video. This is Future Knight, ladies and gentlemen, signing off.